What's going on, YouTube? Prince JMO back here with another video. It has been a while since I have sat down and talked about the Final Fantasy series. Why? Because it sucks now. So in this video, I'm going to talk about why the Final Fantasy series sucks now. These are just my opinions and views. It is not a blanket opinion of all fans, but I'm going to just go over my reasons. Now, number one, the love story is gone. Ever since the end of Final Fantasy X, every installment after that, every sequel, it has always felt like something has been missing. This point, of course, has generational bias. However, a huge thing that sucked us into the Final Fantasy games was that it was Disney, except for teenagers and adults. A grown man could play Final Fantasy, or a teenage boy could play Final Fantasy. And you know, you see the romance and all that, but you could just push all that aside and go, well, he taking his Gunblade, his Buster Sword, and chopping off heads and everything. So yeah, it was Disney for teenagers and adults. There was always a couple with a romantic air surrounding them that always centered around the main character primarily. Examples being Cloud and Tifa, Squall and Ultimecia, Rinoa, Zidane and Dagger, Princess Garnet, Tidus and Yuna. That was always a key element to the game, but it wasn't the primary focus of the game. Since 10, we've had 11. We had 12, which was... And then we had 13, which was...
Well, there I was thinking it was just me that had a problem, but it turns out it's the air conditioning that's sexist.
I know. So many women in our office have the exact same problem. You know, we just sit there absolutely freezing at our desks trying to type. You can probably tell I've got a cold right now, which I blame all on the AC. And so it's just so actually quite nice to see this research. It's just such a relief to know that there's actually proof that this is happening, that women, you know, do feel the cold more than men, and that the AC in offices is normally regulated more for a male's temperature than a woman's.
And it's an explanation for these constant battles.
Then we had 14, which was... They say you can't judge a book by its cover, but in gaming, we definitely do. When I first saw the trailer for Final Fantasy XIV, he's on the throne, the sword spinning in circles, I was intrigued and thought it looked amazing and that I would love to play this game. Then I learned about the boy band part and I was immediately turned off by it. Now, before the 12, 13, and 14 fans, you know, grab their torches and pitchforks and attack me, keep in mind, I'm merely interpreting a fan's perception of the game from the outside. If I look on the cover of Final Fantasy and it's a bunch of dudes all laying on top of each other, am I really gonna wanna buy that? I mean, there's a portion of the fan base that loves the yaoi, but I like the old school romance side, and I'm sure a lot of fans do as well. You see guys riding ships and everything with Tifa in this one, primarily Cloud, Rinoa this one, you know, Irvine and Selphie. You know, it happens a lot. Fans love to, you know, ship characters, and it's hard to even think about shipping someone with Lightning because she's so manly. Oh, next point, the obsession with Seven and ignoring the others. Final Fantasy VII is a groundbreaker. It really was, but the fact that they've made so many spinoffs and sequels to this game while at the same time ignoring all the others is a major turnoff. I know it is for me, and I guarantee you that anyone who's a fan of 6, 4, 5, 8, 9, maybe even a fan of 12 probably feels a way about the fact that 13 of all games got two sequels, while None of the other ones did, you know. Seven's sequels, like, the fact that they're remaking Seven, I don't think anyone has a problem with that. It kind of deserves it. But the fact that you gave a full-blown movie to Seven, and you gave all these extra side games, Crisis Core, Dirge of Cerberus, and all this extra stuff to Seven, and no energy has been put forward towards any of the other games. Don't nobody hold up the Final Fantasy 1 remake that they do every year. That one don't count, man. I'm talking about the big hitters, you know, the Kefka games, the Ultimishas, the Kuja, the, you know, those type of ones that fans to this day still talk about. And it's like, they haven't even touched on the idea of doing anything with them. And fans have asked for it for so long. Instead, it's, oh, we're going to do something with 7. And not to mention Kingdom Hearts 3, Cloud and Squall aren't even in that game at all. Which, Now, next point. The turn-based system being gone. Now, some people are in favor of this. Other people are not. One of the things that got me into Final Fantasy younger was the turn-based system, because it was different. You know, all the other, you know, RPG-esque games that I was playing at the time, because I came over from as being a Nintendo guy, you know, it was all about the Zelda games, you know? And basically, the Final Fantasy fight system, the Kingdom Hearts fight system, now, it's basically the Zelda system, but with a damn cursor on the side of the damn screen for the most part. You can run, you can jump, you can do all this same stuff you do in the damn Zelda game now. Which, I mean, some people are in favor of, some people are not. But to me, if you had to go with what was the greatest fighting system ever created by Final Fantasy, I'm going with 10 off the top of the head. The 10 fight system, the spear grid, all that was dope to me. Especially once you understood the spear grid and how it worked. At first, I think that first few times you were tinkering with it, it was a bit like, huh? But then after a while, you were like, oh, I get it. So I love what they did with the spear grid system and the combat system, where you could swap in and out characters and level them up the way you wanted to, rather than the game forcing you to level up only the main character. I like that. But I want to give a shout out to another game, which to me had the best fighting system. It had its flaws, but if I were to say you want to do, you know, a bit more with the fighting system, but still keep it turn-based, Legend of Dragoon. Legend of Dragoon is an, oh my god, it is a hidden gem. If you've never played it, it's a PS1 game. You can probably see it, find it in the PlayStation 4 for $5-$10. That is a game that every RPG fan should play. I swear to you, oh man, I kind of want to swear on the life of my son, but I kind of want to, but oh man, I'm not going to, but I kind of want to. Legend of Dragoon is that game that should be played by every RPG fan. Legend of Dragoon, Chrono Trigger, like, there's certain games that need to be played. The only thing is Legend of Dragoon, it got so overlooked because of its time. But yeah, the turn-based combat system being gone in favor of this one, yeah. And this is probably the biggest reason of all why Final Fantasy sucks now. The gaming industry as a whole has changed. Gaming is different in today's age. You know, during the PlayStation 1 and the PlayStation 2 era of gaming, RPGs stood out with the aspect of grinding, leveling up characters, weapons, and having deep stories, breathtaking cutscenes. Now, all games, whether it's a first-person shooter, an action, or even a puzzle game, has all those same exact elements. The little things that made RPGs stand out from the pack are gone now. So what does Final Fantasy do? Final Fantasy could simply do all those things again, but a million times better. I mean, just because out of the nowhere, you know, I mean, if I'm playing basketball, you know, and basketball has been dominated by primarily black people for the last forever. And out of the blue, here comes, oh, white boys are dunking now. Asian boys are dunking now. Indian boys are dunking now. Okay, maybe y'all can dunk now, but y'all can't do this. And start doing windmills and all that. You know, it's like Final Fantasy, you've been doing this for years. You, Star Ocean, all these games, Dragon Quest, you did it before they did it. So you should be doing it better. The leveling up system, like the spear grid, bruh. Go back to the spear grid. The love stories within a game, bruh. Look at 8. Look at Final Fantasy 8. Even 7. 7, they didn't lay it on as thick, but damn. Cloud was a man. That man was doing everything to lay that pipe. Tidus, I thought Tidus was gay at first. Like, am I the only one who thought Tidus was gay at the beginning? And it really took him getting in that lake with Yuna for me to go, oh, okay, all right, he's straight. Or he's at least bisexual. Even Seymour didn't seem that damn gay. Tidus seemed pretty gay. Am I the one who felt that way about Tidus? Let me know. But yeah, those are a few reasons why Final Fantasy just isn't what it was. At least to me personally. That's all I got. I'm out.